Madam Chair and members of the committee, it's a great time to be chair of the Transportation Subcommittee of the Senate Finance and Appropriations Committee. After 27 years of not doing a whole lot and 27 years between major bills, we've been moving forward aggressively, collectively, in the General Assembly, but also with the administration on things. Just in the last 3 years, we've addressed funding issues related to Metro, to some of the transit systems across the Commonwealth, to additional roadways in Virginia, and to dealing with the I-81 corridor and the interstate system. Your Transportation Subcommittee this year has reviewed the Governor's introduced budget for the Transportation Secretariat. We endorse his recommendation to allocate funding among our multimodal transportation agencies from new revenues that will be realized as the result of legislation currently under consideration by the 2020 General Assembly. Our proposed amendments build on the steps already taken and increase accountability and oversight, such as of the nascent Virginia Passenger Rail Authority as it comes into existence in the coming years. As a result of actions the Senate has already taken this year, and accounting for the increased revenues assumed in the introduced budget, our proposed amendments allocate more than $700 million throughout Virginia, urban and rural, in a dynamic new transportation revenue across all of our major transportation agencies, including $350 million in critically needed highway construction and maintenance funding, $300 million in new funding for necessary investments in transit and rail programs, $30 million dedicated to address ongoing staffing and retention issues at the Department of Motor Vehicles, and additional revenues dedicated to the Port Authority, Spaceport, and Aviation agencies. With this historic level of new funding and other proposals, including the new Passenger Rail Authority, the potential for major investments in offshore wind energy projects at the Port of Virginia, the subcommittee recommends that the legislature remain prudent stewards of these public investments. Accordingly, the subcommittee recommends that prior to the Commonwealth entering into long-term contractual agreements with private sector partners, proposals for investments in enhanced passenger rail capacity or for energy-related economic development initiatives be subject to thorough review by the MEI Project Approval Commission. Additionally, the subcommittee recommends that we begin planning today for the mobility needs of our future. We believe that now is the time to begin evaluating mobility options along the Route 1 corridor in an effort to assess the most cost-effective approaches for mass transit throughout one of our fastest-growing regions. We further recommend that the time to begin planning for additional passenger rail services not only along Virginia's Golden Crescent corridor, but west to Roanoke and beyond is now. Madam Chair, this completes the report of your Transportation Subcommittee.